This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about how to find the equation of a polynomial function when you're given the graph of the function. So let's start with this graph. Let's say that the function we want to find is p of x. And let's use the graph to find out what the factors of that polynomial are going to be. The graph goes through the point x equals negative 4, so that means one of the factors is going to be x plus 4. It also goes through the origin, so that means one of the factors is x. And it goes through x equals positive 3, so a third factor is going to be x minus 3. And then we want to find out what constant might be multiplying these three factors. So we're going to call the constant a, and we'll find out what that constant is by using this point that I've got here. I've got this point 2 comma 3, which lies on the graph. So the 2 is an x value, the 3 is a y value. I'll take the 3 and put that in where I have p of x. So I'm going to have 3 equals a times, now I want to take the 2 and put it in everywhere where I have an x. So that's going to be 2 plus 4 times 2 times 2 minus 3. So let's work that out and find out what the a is. I'm going to have 3 equals a times 2 plus 4 is 6 times 2. 2 minus 3 is negative 1. I'll multiply those. I'm going to get 3 equals 6 times 2 is 12, times negative 1 is negative 12. So 3 equals negative 12a. I'll multiply both sides by negative 12. And that means that a is going to equal negative 1 quarter. So that means the constant that's multiplying these factors is going to be negative 1 quarter. Okay? So what we've got here is the equation for the polynomial function. P of x equals negative 1 quarter times x plus 4 times x minus 3. You can leave the answer like this, or if you want to, or if your teacher wants you to, you can multiply this all out and get an answer in standard form. Okay, let's try one more. This is a graph that's going to have some multiplicities in it. So once again, let's call this function p of x. And the graph touches the x-axis at x equals negative 2. So that means one of my factors is going to be x plus 2. But notice that it touches it and turns around. It doesn't go through the x-axis. That means that there's going to be a multiplicity here. It's going to be an even multiplicity. So let's say that's x plus 2 squared. It also goes through the x-axis at x equals 1, so that means the other factor I'm going to have is x minus 1, but it doesn't go straight through. It makes this S-curve. So that's telling me there's another multiplicity. If it makes an S-curve like that, it's going to be an odd multiplicity. So let's call that x minus 1 to the third power. And then we're going to need some point so we can find out what the constant a is. We've got a point, it's on the y-axis at negative 2. So we've got a point 0 comma negative 2 where the graph crosses the y-axis. So the 0 is an x value, the negative 2 is a y value. I'll put in negative 2 equals a. Let me fix this a over here. A times, let's see, x was 0. 0 plus 2 is 2, so that's going to be 2 squared. And then I've got x minus 1, so that's 0 minus 1, or just negative 1, to the third power. So I've got negative 2 equals a. 2 squared is 4, so that's a times 4, and negative 1 to the third power is negative 1. So I'm going to have negative 2 equals negative 4a. I'll divide both sides by negative 4. And I'm going to have a equals 1/2. So the constant over here, the a, is 1/2. Okay, so the equation for this polynomial function is p of x equals negative one, equals 1/2 times x plus 2 squared times x minus 1 to the third power. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.